Aaron Cookies Angels. What are we making today, Nonna Teresa?
Savoiardi.
Savoiardi. Cookies, biscotti. So let's say you want to make a tiramisu, but you didn't find the Savoiardi. You can make your own Savoiardi. Regular Savoiardi or also gluten-free Savoiardi. It's up to you. You just switch the regular flour with a gluten-free flour. Super simple. It's unbelievable how this biscotto is so simple to make. And like I said, you can make it for the tiramisu or you can just eat it as is, right? For breakfast. All you need, 3 ingredients. Incredible. Eggs. Actually 4, sorry. Eggs. Plain flour, all-purpose flour, sugar, and this is my personal touch, but you don't have to add it, a little vanilla extract. That's all. We start from the eggs. So let's do this way. Bracket. They're pretty tough. You want to separate the yolks from the whites, okay? So whites on one side, on one bowl. It's very important that you separate the yolk and the white with this technique without cracking the yolk. No yolk in the whites, not even a little bit. Otherwise, it's not gonna work, okay? So yolks in here. Nonna, you do the other one. Why that? With the white, we need to make some meringue. And for some scientific reason, if you get egg yolk in there, you won't be able to whip the meringue and make whip the egg white and make meringue with it. Perfetto. Allora, on this side, Nonna's corner, we're gonna add a small tablespoon of sugar. Here, on my side, one tablespoon, small tablespoon per yolk. So one and two, and a teeny tiny bit of vanilla extract, okay? That will give a little extra flavor. I mix it first like this, otherwise it's gonna splash everywhere. And then with the mixer. And I usually do this technique here. With the spatula, you just push everything towards the whisks. And you wanna make it nice and smooth and foamy until all the sugar is dissolved in the yolk. So go as fast as you can. Let's see who finishes first. So Nonna is making a meringue. I'm making zabaglione. Okay? Let's keep going. Which, by the way, is also very similar to the tiramisu cream. So the only difference between Savoiardi biscotti and the tiramisu cream is that in the cream you add mascarpone, which is an Italian cream cheese, the tiramisu cream. In the Savoiardi, you just switch that with some flour. Like I said, you want to make it gluten-free flour. Regular biscotti, regular flour. So easy. I hold it on the side like this. See how it's changing texture and color? Guarda la nonna. Let's keep mixing. Nonna, when you're done, please help me with this. Andatinito. No rush. Make sure that all the sugar is dissolved here and make sure that the meringue is nice and foamy. The peaks. You have to look for the peaks. Okay. Lascio un attimo, nonna, please. Aiutami un secondino con la spatola. Turn it on. Bravo, push everything down. It's almost done. Eh? Let's show them. See how thick it's getting? Make sure you get everything, all the sugar that is left on the edges.
See that? That's perfect.
Perfect zabaglione. Next ingredient. Same tablespoon, so you just work with the same sizes because you use the same tablespoon and same dosage for all the ingredients. So with the same tablespoon, 2 heaping tablespoon of regular flour, 1 per yogurt. No, aspetta, non è quello, dobbiamo mix this, sì. 1 and 2, okay?
Vado.
Aspetta, first with this, and then Nonna with that. Vai, let's do it.
Okay.
Mix everything together. It's gonna look very hard in the beginning, but it will be okay. Once you combine everything together. Okay.
Okay. Stop.
Perfetto. Sì, sbatti. Make sure we get everything. All you want to do to finish the cookie dough, the savoyardi dough, is to combine the meringue into this zabaglione and flour base, like this. And very important, do not stir, but fold it in nice and gentle. Right, Nonna? This is very important.
Sì, sì, molto
because
important.
If you mix it, what happens? The meringue loses all the air, it goes back to liquid, and addio savoiardi. Mm-hmm. They're not gonna be nice and spongy like they should be. So let's keep going like this. Like I say, very gentle. Until it's nice and homogeneous and has all the same color. I also go like this a little bit to make sure that it's all mixed in. Start also from the center. Okay. We almost done, Nonna. Let's grab a sac à poche, in Italian, pastry bag. Okay. Oh, it's very fluffy, nice. Super fluffy. I just want to make sure that it's all mixed in. Let me see. Yes, it looks done.
Okay.
Yeah. Bye. You know, a little space. In there. And this is one. Bye. Don't make it super full. Ancora, Nonna? Sì, we want a lot of... Nonna is showing you how to...
Sì.
To squeeze. Beh, that's enough for now.
Okay.
Shake a little bit, make sure it goes down. And then... Tray, Nonna, I want to cut the end, the point, via. No, I'll let you do it. You have a much better hand.
Come li vogliamo fare? Così grandi?
Sì, long, like a real savoiardo, perfetto.
Ok.
So a little flat, because when you cook them, they rise, okay? Not too close to each other, that's important, because they expand a little bit. And in the meanwhile, I sprinkle some sugar on the top. So precise, Nonna. Perfetto, we can stop here, Nonna.
Okay.
Bye. Obviously, before you start, preheat the oven at 360 Fahrenheit to 180 Celsius. They're going for 10 minutes, and I'll show you the final result in a little bit. Right, Nonna?
A tra poco.
See you in a little bit.
And this is what you get after 10 minutes in the oven. Nonna, how are they?
Belli.
Tasting time. Let's try them. Super soft. Now, if you want to make a tiramisu with them, let it cool down. Bake them again at 160 Celsius for another 5 minutes. Okay? So they will be a little harder. Because if you dip them in the coffee now, as is, they will fall apart. They're really soft. They're really good.
Molto buoni.
Enjoy!
Ciao!